roller skated on the sidewalk, went to the beach every day, walked, went to church. There are meetings at church every night, and we always walk to church. All kinds of meetings, youth meetings, socials. It was a Methodist church on 2nd Street. 2nd Street in Stockton. Oh, we went to the Mini Ditch, South Amboy. That's the name of the Mini Ditch. That's where everybody knew, did we?
Yep.
What's the name of the beach? They call it the Mini Ditch because there were always little minis floating in the water, and we had to step around them. A lot of hunting areas, a lot of trails in the woods, because we played in the woods all the time. There were a lot of geese that roamed, and sometimes they came and bothered us children.
Mentioned.
Yes, my father used to go hunting for rabbits, and I would go with him many times. And of course, mother would cook them for supper. We always went sleigh riding in the winter, and we always went for trips through the woods, long walks through the woods. There was nothing else up there, and played in the yard. There wasn't much to do.
Woods?
Yes, we used to go huckleberry picking. Lots of bushes, lots of them. And many, many quarts. We didn't have it hard because my father always had a job.
Right.
We went through a depression without even, I didn't even know it. It wasn't at all. As long as you have a job, it was fine.
Yeah.
Yes, we had a movie theater in town. But of course it was better to go to Perth Amboy. We'd take a bus and go to Perth Amboy to the big movies. Yes, that's where we did all of our shopping. We'd take a bus and go to Perth Amboy and do all of our shopping.
Amboy.
We never had a car. Wherever you went, you had to go by bus. We were satisfied with South Amboy. We never went any distance anywhere. Yes, there was a lot of traffic on Broadway because the highways weren't built yet. And Broadway was the main line to go north. And there was always traffic jams. They're parked one right after another.
Mm-hmm.
It was the main line from the shore. They had to come through town. We went to this elementary school was on 4th Street in South Amboy. Went to Huffman High School. I was a beautician. And my first job was in Princeton. And I had to take a train from South Amboy to Rahway. And I would change at Rahway and cross the tracks and get a train to Princeton. And then at Princeton, I'd get the little local train that went through the campus. It was
wow.
A long ride for the job, but I was young and it was lots of fun. I liked walking through the campus every day. I worked every day. Well, I worked there for about 2 years, and then I got a job local in South Amboy. And I stayed there till maybe 1957, and then I opened my own shop right here in my home. I opened my beauty shop here in 1957. And I worked till I was 85 as a hairdresser. Well, I met my husband at a camp. It was a Bible school camp. And it was in Jobstown, New Jersey. It was for 1 week. It cost $7 a week to go to this camp. I want you to know that. And I met him there, first day I was there. And that's the only boyfriend I had. I was 19, and then he joined the Marines the very next year. In 1939, he joined the Marines and stayed until 1945. And that's where I met him. Oh yes, when he was in the war, he didn't come home very often. And then finally, was gone for 2 years, and he went to Guadalcanal, and he was gone for 2 years before I ever saw him again. But today, they tell you where the boys are all the time, and they come home very often. I worked. We did everything normal. You didn't know what was going on. They didn't tell you where he was. I never knew. Today you hear so much about it that it's always on your mind. We lived normal. We went to New York, we went to the theater, we went all over. And the poor men were away. But it just wasn't much news about them. Home. The first year he came home, we stayed with my mother. Then we bought a house immediately. Came right here, lived here ever since. Well, we lived here for 4 years before we had a car. And about 1948. And other than that, we just took a bus wherever we wanted to go. And this was country up here because my house was the last house on the street. And then it was the woods. And then gradually they kept building houses, one right after another. We bought it from Ed Munn was a contractor, and he built all these houses. And that was in 45. Yes, we all socialized when the children were young. Yeah, we had a lot of good times with children playing together. Every house had children. I had three. My sister had five boys. We all went to several schools.